Me 28F with my husband 29M, married 6 years, he made out with another woman last night. Quite a long message, so I truly appreciate anybody taking the time to read this. My partner and our two close friends are tight as can be friendship's goals. I absolutely adore the four of us spending time together, and we have been toying with the idea of the four of us having a foursome, with me being the only one in the group who is bisexual, the others heterosexual. I've had a threesome with two of my closest female friends before I got into a relationship with my current partner. It was fun and amazing, and seriously made our friendship stronger. I have always struggled with my self-esteem and lack of confidence in both my physical ability and my work and creative life. I'm a perfectionist with attention deficit disorder that crushes herself with doubt and angry words when I can't finish tasks. But over the months of quarantine, it has gotten worse. I have developed a very strong hate towards myself, my body, my lack of accomplishments, my sense of feeling unworthy and unhappy with my creative outputs. I paint, illustrate, photograph and edit as a hobby. My partner and I are also moving internationally with our cat. This whole experience has been incredibly stressful, but it's 3 weeks and most things are sorted. On top of this, my grandparents, the people who raised me and are beyond doubt the people I love most in this world who live in a different country, are now on their deathbeds. I feel like I am living on borrowed time. I just want for the next 3 weeks of me working in a lab, finalizing packing and cleaning to be over so I can take that plane to our new home, drop the cat, then head to my grandparents' city with the next flight. To say I am very anxious, incredibly sad, worried, experiencing anticipatory grief, battling intense feelings of self-hatred would be an understatement. Last weekend, we visited our friends in their flat and all three of them seemed pretty keen for our foursome to happen. I told them how I'm feeling, lacking in confidence, worried for my family, and told them I couldn't go through with it as much as I wanted to. They seemed to understand, but I felt incredibly guilty for letting them down. Our friends will be coming to our flat this Saturday for a last catch-up before my partner and I embark on our new adventure abroad. I am utterly devastated. My husband, my best friend, my only love, made out with another woman last night while we were drinking. We are visiting another country and arrived yesterday. We were going to call it an early night but met a nice couple at the hotel bar and stayed up very late drinking. We finally made it back to our room around 3 a.m. and that's when he told me. A bit of backstory here, 4+ years ago, we were into swinging. It was always consensual and we never did anything without the other person there. It all ended when we moved to another city and I started my career. I also gained some weight and didn't feel comfortable meeting up with other couples anymore. I communicated this to him and I thought we had a mutual understanding that that period of our relationship was over. He told me he made out with her while they were out to get cigarettes. Once at the subway station and once in the elevator, his excuse was that he was trying to start a foursome with the other couple. He brought it up to her after they kissed and she said she didn't think her BF, who I was with in their hotel room, would be into it. My husband and I are extremely close. We do just about everything together and our friends always tell us how adorable we are. We've been together all in all 9 years, married 6 years this September. I am sick to my stomach. I don't know what to do. All this time we have had together and it just makes me so utterly broken that he would kiss another woman. We have 6 more days on this vacation and it is absolutely ruined. What do I do? Can I forgive him? Should I forgive him? Please help. Story 2, my 35F husband 33M is unrealistically obsessed with planning our next S-time adventure. Throw away for dirty S-time reasons. So, my husband and I have been married for about a year and a half, together a bit over 4 years. Our S-time life has always been good overall, although mostly dependent on his libido, which can vary from 10-10 to 2-10 depending on his work schedule. He works up to 90-hour weeks. We aren't really that kinky overall, but we do like a little dirty talk, and we'd always talked about either me having S-time with another guy or having a foursome with another couple. We'd look at Craigslist or swinger sites before having s time to kind of go along with the fantasy. Eventually we found a few people we thought it might actually be fun to do it with, and we began responding to ads. We really clicked with one couple and had s time with them a few times. It was super fun, we all became friends, and there were surprisingly zero issues. No jealousy, no imbalances, just fun. Now the kind of weird part is that both me and the wife of the other couple were pregnant while all this was going on. Weird, but it worked. But when the babies were born, it wasn't exactly a super S-timey time, and a few months later, we moved to another state. Now we have a cute 6-month-old who is adorable in every way except that she's a S-E sleeper. She wakes up every 2 hours and I'm the only one who can get her to sleep. My husband is back to looking at ads for foursomes. He has a tendency to get a little obsessive and is doing it constantly. I'm not bothered that he wants to do it again, but it's annoying me that he keeps pestering about it when there is no way in hell we can accomplish this until the baby is more settled and we can actually use a babysitter. I did agree to meet one couple for drinks, and we didn't really have chemistry. Plus, we had a 2-hour window to do it while she was with my mom, which was weird. The administrative tasks associated with finding the right couple are super annoying too. And finally, I don't feel all that S-timey since I'm still breastfeeding, have a big C-section scar, and a few extra pounds. Breastfeeding also kind of suppresses your libido. So my problem is that I want to keep the fantasy alive for the sake of our S-time life, but my husband is oblivious to the fact that this is really unrealistic right now. I don't know how to shut him down without him getting weird about it and making this his secret obsession. I know that if I don't participate in the fantasy, he'll feel like he's burdening me and get shameful about it and hide his interest, which then makes the obsession worse. Story 3. I 25F feel like my partner 30M is guilt-tripping me into having a foursome with our two best friends 25F. Quite a long message, so I truly appreciate anybody taking the time to read this. My partner and our two close friends are tight as can be friendship's goals. I absolutely adore the four of us spending time together, and we have been toying with the idea of the four of us having a foursome, with me being the only one in the group who is bisexual, the others heterosexual. I've had a threesome with two of my closest female friends before I got into a relationship with my current partner. It was fun and amazing, and seriously made our friendship stronger. I have always struggled with my self-esteem and lack of confidence in both my physical ability and my work and creative life. I'm a perfectionist with attention deficit disorder that crushes herself with doubt and angry words when I can't finish tasks. But over the months of quarantine, it has gotten worse. I have developed a very strong hate towards myself, my body, my lack of accomplishments, my sense of feeling unworthy and unhappy with my creative outputs. I paint, illustrate, photograph and edit as a hobby. My partner and I are also moving internationally with our cat. This whole experience has been incredibly stressful, but it's 3 weeks and most things are sorted. On top of this, my grandparents, the people who raised me and are beyond doubt the people I love most in this world who live in a different country, are now on their deathbeds. I feel like I am living on borrowed time. I just want for the next 3 weeks of me working in a lab, finalizing packing and cleaning to be over so I can take that plane to our new home, drop the cat, then head to my grandparents' city with the next flight. To say I am very anxious, incredibly sad, worried, experiencing anticipatory grief, battling intense feelings of self-hatred would be an understatement. Last weekend, we visited our friends in their flat and all three of them seemed pretty keen for our foursome to happen. I told them how I'm feeling, elking in confidence, worried for my family, and told them I couldn't go through with it as much as I wanted to. They seemed to understand, but I felt incredibly guilty for letting them down. Our friends will be coming to our flat this Saturday for a last catch-up before my partner and I embark on our new adventure abroad. My partner asked me yesterday if I would be up for the foursome this weekend. I know this experience has been his hugest sexual fantasy for many years now, and I want to be part of this experience with him. He said that as a man, this sort of opportunity rarely comes, and when it does, it should be taken advantage of. He said that we would all have fun, seeing as we are all friends, and that, seeing as all three of these people greatly love me, it would be a wonderful experience for me, something I do not disagree with. I got very sad, straight away, and basically attacked him with, "It hurts me so much that you care more about your pleasure than my mental health." I explained how not only am I super low in confidence, but that I cannot do something like this with the weight of my grandparents' death hanging over me. I truly did see his points. I choose not to act out of fear that something bad may happen, but ignore the fact that something good may happen too. This experience may be what my confidence needs to feel better, but in my very sensitive state just now, feel like it would do me more harm than good. A metaphor to better express how I am feeling: this foursome is like ice cream. I love ice cream, would completely eat the whole tub in one sitting. But I currently have a super sore throat, and the thought of most foods makes me feel worse. I still want to eat the ice cream, I just want to wait for a time where my throat isn't sore. My partner seemed to understand, but was acting cold afterwards. He said he respects my decision but is very disappointed and feels that he shouldn't have to hide it. I told him this could happen in the future when I feel less awful, but seeing as we're moving countries, and by the time we see our friends again they may be in relationships of their own, this might be a now or never situation. I feel like I am letting everyone down. I also feel like my partner is guilting into not doing this, as a much happier version of me would be down for it. I'm also disappointed. I thought I made it clear to all three of them last Saturday that I wasn't down for it just now, but he still insisted yesterday. I genuinely do feel like he cares more about himself than me sometimes. I feel like I need someone to hold me. I am losing my most cherished people in the world and can't do anything about it because death comes for us all, but I am made to feel guilty that I can't just move past my insecurities and give him and my friends what they want. If only I felt better, things would be different. Edit: the amount of support I have obtained from the community is truly astounding. I was not expecting anybody to reply, and I cannot begin to thank each and every one of you who took the time to wish me well, to make sure I look out for myself, to offer your concern to a stranger on the internet. In between me writing the post initially and today, I have had a very open talk with my partner and we sorted out a few things. My partner has always been incredibly supportive, but my mental health has never been worse, and never for this long. I think the sooner I speak to a professional about some other deep-rooted issues, I may be able to get my bearings. I have relied on my partner for literally everything lately, and he's been brought to the breaking point. We're taking it slow. Again, thank you to everyone who has wished me well. As many of you flagged out, it's difficult to get the full picture. It's hard to concisely describe myself or my partner, to give the internet a good representation of who we are. I have read through all the adifs and suggestions given, but will, as is only fair, act accordingly to what I know best helps my situation. He is for the most part the most supportive human I have ever come across, and has had my back through so many tough situations, this week's incident being the only time I felt his support falter, partly due, as he made me understand, to the fact that he is also very emotionally fatigued, like me. Much love everyone, take care. Redditor's reactions. Redditor 1, don't feel pressured into doing something that you don't feel ready to do. It's your body and your partner should be considerate of your feelings. Think about how you would react if they said the same thing. Don't feel guilty about this. Op answer, thank you. If the roles were reversed, I would be supportive of their decision and like to think that I wouldn't be so implicit with my disappointment. Redditor 2, definitely don't do it. I was in a relationship like this where my ex-partner had often used the same justifications for threesomes, foursomes, etc. Although these were also fantasies of mine, he often effers the subject during times where I felt uncomfortable. I was scared of losing him and felt selfish, insecure, so I went through with it anyway. Safe to say, he thought they were great experiences, while I ended up feeling worse. And if I did say no, He resented guilted me for months after. Never do anything you're not 100% with. A good partner shouldn't push you to do anything you're even slightly unsure about, either. You deserve some time to heal and focus on your mental health without anyone pressuring you. Don't settle for anything less than that. Op answer, I'm sorry to hear the experience on your end was not a fortunate one and that you ended up feeling worse just to appease your ex. Live and learn, and now you're sharing this experience with me and I am so appreciative. I am bisexual and would love for an experience like this, just not now. I am afraid he will resent my decision later on the line. He is genuinely for the most part a really good partner, but with recent events I am feeling a disconnect. Redditor 3, you are clearly not in the place mentally for this to happen. Your BF is an absolute ducking a shoal for two reasons. It should be obvious you aren't in a position to do this in your current state. He is pressuring you. Your friends are a shoals too. They should have your back. He should feel guilty, not you. Do not do this. You don't owe him his fantasy. Op answer, is there even a point to confronting him about this? That as much as past me wanted this to happen, I'm too far down the rabbit hole of negativity to do so now? I agree with you, but I want this relationship to work and I do want to confront him but know he will feel attacked. Redditor 4, I don't really get one thing. Why do your straight female friends want a foursome with other girls involved? Is there a way to let them have an active role in it and for you to just watch or SMTH? You shouldn't feel efforts to do anything you don't want to do BTW, but yay. Unless you find a kink community, I doubt this chance will present itself another time. Redditor follow up, yeah, it really sounds like Op gets the least out of this scenario. I'm bi, for reference, and I can't imagine wanting to sleep with straight women they're not attracted to Op, and it seems pretty guaranteed it's just about servicing her boyfriend's being there. That's why he's acting like such a child because it's a scenario that revolves purely around him. Like, even if they tried to get Op off, it sounds very fetishistic in a woman performing S-time acts together for a man's gratification rather than because they want to have S-time with Op, her boyfriend, and the other woman. Op, I know you've said you have low self-esteem but I think you've hit the nail on the head when you said your boyfriend cares more about this foursome than your mental health. I think you need to tell him, and then your two friends, that this is entirely off the table for however long you need it to be, whether you say a specific length of time or just go, we need to not talk about this for as long as I need to recover mentally, and when I feel comfortable I'll bring it up again. Your friends should respect that, at least, if they're good friends. If they don't respect that or your boyfriend doesn't, you need to seriously re-evaluate whether you're okay having people treat your health like it's dog waste on the tip of their shoes. Edit, and don't feel guilty about saying no. You have the right to say no to whatever S-time acts you want to say no to, even in the middle of them, and anyone who makes you feel guilty or ashamed for exercising your fundamental right to consent is a genuinely awful person. Good people care about their partner S's and friend S's consent, no matter whether they're disappointed enough. Your boyfriend is 30, he can put on his big boy pants and not be openly disappointed around you. Redditor 5, you're absolutely right that he cares more about his own sexual fantasy than your mental health. You hit the nail on the head. Is this someone you really, truly see yourself spending the rest of your life with? I'm not going to speak on the foursome. Personally, I would never be okay with my partner hooking up with friends, even if I was a part of it. But the way he treats you. You say sometimes you think he cares more about himself than you. Is that something you're okay with in the long run? I think you deserve love and kindness and respect, and this is not really all of those things. Op answer, I do see a future with him. Overall, he provides the emotional support. This is why this instance is so incredibly shocking to me. I did not see it coming. I sometimes think he cares more about himself than me because, coming from this low confidence hole, I feel that with everyone, regardless. I agree with you. I wish to raise this with him again, but I am genuinely afraid I will make things worse. Thank you for your comment, though. My partner asked me yesterday if I would be up for the foursome this weekend. I know this experience has been his hugest sexual fantasy for many years now, and I want to be part of this experience with him. He said that as a man, this sort of opportunity rarely comes, and when it does, it should be taken advantage of. He said that we would all have fun, seeing as we are all friends, and that, seeing as all three of these people greatly love me, it would be a wonderful experience for me, something I do not disagree with. I got very sad, straight away, and basically attacked him with, "It hurts me so much that you care more about your pleasure than my mental health." I explained how not only am I super low in confidence, but that I cannot do something like this with the weight of my grandparents' death hanging over me. I truly did see his points. I choose not to act out of fear that something bad may happen, but ignore the fact that something good may happen too. This experience may be what my confidence needs to feel better, but in my very sensitive state just now, feel like it would do me more harm than good. A metaphor to better express how I am feeling: this foursome is like ice cream. I love ice cream, would completely eat the whole tub in one sitting. But I currently have a super sore throat, and the thought of most foods makes me feel worse. I still want to eat the ice cream, I just want to wait for a time where my throat isn't sore. My partner seemed to understand, but was acting cold afterwards. He said he respects my decision but is very disappointed and feels that he shouldn't have to hide it. I told him this could happen in the future when I feel less awful, but seeing as we're moving countries, and by the time we see our friends again they may be in relationships of their own, this might be a now or never situation. I feel like I am letting everyone down. I also feel like my partner is guilting into not doing this, as a much happier version of me would be down for it. I'm also disappointed. I thought I made it clear to all three of them last Saturday that I wasn't down for it just now, but he still insisted yesterday. I genuinely do feel like he cares more about himself than me sometimes. I feel like I need someone to hold me. I am losing my most cherished people in the world and can't do anything about it because death comes for us all, but I am made to feel guilty that I can't just move past my insecurities and give him and my friends what they want. If only I felt better, things would be different. TLDR, apologies for this long message. I am very hurt and would appreciate anyone's contribution on this matter. I also wonder if I am even entitled to feel this way. There's just so much guilt. Edit: the amount of support I have obtained from the community is truly astounding. I was not expecting anybody to reply, and I cannot begin to thank each and every one of you who took the time to wish me well, to make sure I look out for myself, to offer your concern to a stranger on the internet. In between me writing the post initially and today, I have had a very open talk with my partner and we sorted out a few things. My partner has always been incredibly supportive, but my mental health has never been worse, and never for this long. I think the sooner I speak to a professional about some other deep-rooted issues, I may be able to get my bearings. I have relied on my partner for literally everything lately, and he's been brought to the breaking point. We're taking it slow. Again, thank you to everyone who has wished me well. As many of you flagged out, it's difficult to get the full picture. It's hard to concisely describe myself or my partner, to give the internet a good representation of who we are. I have read through all the adifs and suggestions given, but will, as is only fair, act accordingly to what I know best helps my situation. He is for the most part the most supportive human I have ever come across, and has had my back through so many taut situations, this week's incident being the only time I felt his support falter, partly due, as he made me understand, to the fact that he is also very emotionally fatigued, like me. Much love everyone, take care. 3.